law. When I was 13, I created a website called QL Mentoring to help mentor and support bright children with autism and learning differences. I do research at UCL to help further our understanding of autism, and I'm passionate about diversity in STEM. There is no doubt that being autistic, dyslexic, and dyspraxic, and having ADHD presents lots of challenges at school and in the workplace. However, by far, the biggest challenge I have faced throughout my life is intolerance. I have been relentlessly bullied at school for no other reason than that I am different. Some of the greatest scientific contributions have come from people who are neurodiverse. People like Cavendish, Newton, Darwin, and Einstein. Today, neurodiverse students have such hostile educational experiences and such traumatic bullying experiences that many of us are forced into home education, develop PTSD, and other mental health issues. Society's intolerance has consequences. How many brilliant minds, how many future innovators, change makers, how many problem solvers and pioneers, how many visionaries will fail to develop their scientific talents? By failing neurodiverse students, how much one-of-a-kind talent will be stifled and lost to humanity? We should be identifying and nurturing neurodiverse talent. I am extremely lucky in that my parents were able to send me to summer programs in the United States that were designed for gifted students with STEM. At the age of 10, I was studying Newtonian physics and general and special relativity at Stanford University's Pre-Collegiate Summer Institute. I have spent every summer since studying high-level physics and math in the United States. Last summer, I spent 2 weeks studying theoretical physics at Perimeter Institute in Canada. These programs were transformational. For the first time in my life, I belonged and was accepted and embraced for who I was. I was celebrated for my love of physics and math, for my thirst of knowledge, and for my intellectual curiosity. At these programs, I was no longer a weirdo or a freak. I no longer had to hide my passions and pretend to be someone I was not. Unfortunately, there are no similar programs in the United Kingdom. My hope is that UK universities will create them. They will create STEM programs that identify and nurture neurodiverse STEM talent early. STEM programs that are not only intellectually stimulating, but also safe haven, where neurodiverse students can be among students like them and can be free to be themselves and feel less isolated and alone. I am a student representative of 2Empower, a project that aims to mentor and support high-ability neurodiverse students to excel in STEM. Our aim is to ensure that neurodiverse STEM talent is nurtured and developed. We run workshops at Imperial College specifically tailored for students with learning differences, and workshops tailored for autistic students. Our workshops have a phenomenal response, because for many of the autistic students, it is the first time they've met someone like them, and the first time programs have been designed to cater to their needs. I believe that people who think differently and who see the world differently have a lot to contribute to science and society. I believe we need to develop these and harness these unique talents, innovative insights, and creative problem-solving skills. I hope that you believe this.